You'd be killed tonight.
I got shot at 80, 87, 88, 89, and 90.
I lost my brother-in-law.
They're gonna come by with, on the drive-by, you know, you can't do nothing. You're gonna react.
You have to stay locked up in your house. You can't go out there and sit on your porch because you have to worry about if a car passed by and their lights out, you know somebody's getting ready to shoot.
How come peace isn't possible?
I think it's possible, but nobody don't want it. I don't know. We tried to make a peace before, but it just didn't work.
They were trying to hit me and him, but they ended up hitting her.
Innocent people, the ones who always get shot. And the girls do drive-by shooters, too.
Do you fear dying?
Not since I got shot.
How many of you have brothers that are in gangs? What do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be alive.
If I were to throw a concert and there were some Bloods and they're your enemies, would you give me your word on a day of peace?
Yeah, man. Here I am sitting across from my enemy and there's no violence in it, you know?
Couldn't be done. They said, oh, you can't get those people together. Damn it, they'll start slapping each other.
Of course, we did have you go through metal detectors because we ain't stupid either.
See, it's harder for a woman to go through a metal detector because you got so much metal. You know? Yeah.
Excuse me, could you do that again?
Oh, all right. Take those earrings off. They're apparently not gold. If they were gold, they wouldn't make that noise. That's right. I've been going to your neighborhoods, man. I met some different things, man. Not strange, just different. For example, it seems like every car that goes by, you guys. What was that? Oh, nothing, man. I'm out there interviewing a brother, so tell me about the neighborhood. He goes, yeah, I'll tell you in a minute. Yeah, you know. I said, are you nervous about nothing? No, man, this is my aerobics. This is how we lose weight in the hood. I see y'all dancing too, man. You know, I gotta say this, my brothers, my black brothers and sisters, y'all get down. That's it, man. They've been moving that booty everywhere. Woo. Excuse me, I say move, eh? I'm about to dance over there. I don't want to have to bump your ass out the club. Because then you don't have to pay another cover charge to come back in. My homeboys, the vatos, you know how they dance? Vatos are too cool. Vatos just dance like that. Their old ladies get mad and go, hey, little frog, dance. He goes, I'm dancing, eh? That's how I dance, eh? And when the music's really good, they really do it. They go. Yeah, I'm really into it now, eh? White people can't dance. I'm sorry.
Ever see white people try to dance? How do you do this? How? I'm feeling really funky right now. Hey, hey! Poison, poison, poison! OPP! Hey, buddy, you know me. I was thinking about what to wear tonight, right? Because colors are so important. So I just want you vatos who are looking at me, I want you to know this ain't blue. This is periwinkle. This is periwinkle. And these are my khakis, you know. You know, if you're Hispanic, you gotta wear these. No, no. These ain't no Dockers or 501s. These are JCPenney's, eh? My favorite show on television is Cops. Because that's the only time you get to see your relatives in underwear being arrested. You ever see that? That show is so cool, man. You'd be out there, we'd be sitting there, see blacks and Hispanics. We watch Cops. Them too. Hey, man, we're not Hispanics, eh? We're Latinos. All right. So what's the difference? He goes, Latinos got jobs, eh? I grew up in Compton. Okay, I'm really not from there. Compton is a wonderful place if you're a gun. I did. My father didn't want me to join no gangs. I said, hey, Dad, I want to join the Boy Scouts. He goes, hey, I don't want you to join no gangs. I goes, that's the Boy Scouts, Dad. They ain't no gang. He goes, what's the difference? They wear khakis. They got pocket knives. They go to youth camp. The street I grew up in Compton, you see, most of the gangs, they take the name of the street where you're from. You know, that's your... My street, man, I used to live on St. Agnes. We were known as the Vatos from St. Agnes. Wasn't nobody afraid of us. Girl Scouts used to take our money. Come on, man, let's go mess with these St. Agnes Vatos. We used to hold hands, sing Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya, orale pues, Kumbaya. One thing I learned walking into your neighborhoods is that nobody knows nothing. You ask them, excuse me, what did you see? I didn't see nothing. Well, did you hear something? I didn't hear nothing. But you was looking right at you. I was looking, but I wasn't seeing. I was listening, but I wasn't hearing, man. I don't know nothing. And I asked you all in this show, you'll see, why are you battling? Why are you shooting each other? Why are you hurting each other? And I got some very, very deep answers. Like, But what are you doing? Well, who started? When is it gonna end? It's like, But it's the truth. But tonight, man, I am proud of you. I am proud of you, man. Because tonight we're going to show the rest of the world and all those homeboys and all those hoods that are watching us across the country that this is possible. If we can have a night of truce for one night, maybe we can have a night of truce for a week. And if we get to a week, you know we can have a month. And once we get to a month, we got a year. And when we get to a year, we ain't never fighting no more. You guys are Clarence. Clarence Street locals, you derive your name from Clarence Street, right? Yeah. Who do you guys get along with? Who do you guys throw pedo with?
We don't get along with nobody.
You don't get along with nobody?
Or half a project.
Half the project?
Yeah.
Just in this area alone, there's better than 10 gangs, right?
Yeah.
10 barrios, right? And they all, a lot of those barrios crisscross each other as far as their territory.
Yeah.
What are the boundaries of your territory?
Well, it's like we got three, because we got different places.
This is one of our neighborhood, and we got another one in the projects. Yeah, over here, in La Fuente. We got San Diego.
Where did we become enemies?
As soon as you cross that freeway.
And the battle is over what? Over what? Territory?
That's what it looks like.
It isn't over money?
No.
It isn't over rucas?
No drugs, no nothing.
No drugs, no girls, no get. It's territory.
Yeah.
You guys are fighting over the fact that you live here and they live there.
Right.
Here's what I don't understand. Help me out. I'm talking to you all in the middle of the projects over turf. The damn government owns this. Your parents and my parents. We never owned this. You willing to die for something you can't sell?
No, that's way back from about the 40s or something.
That's it. Tell me about that. It started in the 40s. You and I and nobody in this room was born in the 40s. Why didn't that pedo die there?
Just keeps on carrying on.
Can you remember how things have changed from the time you were 13 to, let's say, now?
A lot has changed. I mean, they bring up guns and things. It wasn't like that before, you know. It all started, we used to just have football games with each other. And now, man, you can't even cross that street over there or over here, you know. We go over there, they're going to shoot at us for kill, you know.
For real, yeah, for keeps.
Right.
They used to be toe-to-toe, right?
Right, you know, now it's, it ain't no more chains or nothing, man. It's just automatic weapons, you know.
When was the cuete introduced, the guns?
2 years ago, like 88.
Well, around here was
like 88, 89.
Yeah.
Where do the weapons come from?
Different places.
Yeah,
they're easy to get. Everywhere.
How easy are they to get?
One call away.
2 days.
Day?
Not even
really. Day. You can wait 15 minutes.
They come on the street.
Come up with the money, that's all there's to it.
People that buy drugs can trade their guns for money, you know.
What do you
that
want?
Fast, you can get it.
Say, what do you want? Losing, what, 22? 22 ain't gonna do nothing. I'm talking about 45, 9 minutes.
You mean a perro stopper?
I mean, the thing that snuffed you out.
Do you fear for your life?
Yeah, I do. But, I'm not gonna be inside my house for, you know, 24 hours a day.
So in order for you to have the right to be out, you make them fear for their life.
What you say there?
I could, but did you say that?
Well, you know, they're going to do that to me. I'm going to turn around and do the same, you know what I mean? Somebody pulls out a gun on you, you got one on you, it's who's ever quicker, I guess, you know what I mean?
Do you guys fear for your life?
Right.
You
think get over once in a while, but what can you do about it? You can't really do nothing.
You can get out.
Nah.
Do you ever see an end to this?
Nah, I don't.
Why?
Because there's been gangs since I don't know how long. You think they're gonna stop it?
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for a very, very funny young man. He's a new cast member of In Living Color. Jamie Foxx, give it up! My man.
What's up?
Tear it up.
What's up? Let's get up. So what's up, man? You know, it's good to have you guys here. We got, you know, all these different things that are going on. The people were scared. It was like, people were interviewing me like, Jamie, aren't you scared? Aren't you just scared? I'm like, man, look at these people, man. They're people, man. They're just doing business, but aren't you scared? I'm like, no, man, I'm having a good time. I couldn't get no music. I wanted to come out and say, hoes!
Yeah, any hoes? Any hoes? Any hoes?
Fella's like, yeah, I'm a hoe. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm not. I'm just serious. No, because I'm not. I know ladies get upset when you use that word hoe, man, because you can't use that word in L.A., Jack, because I mess around and call a girl a hoe. Oh, I was just playing you. Because I'm really not looking for a hoe, man. I just take that back. I'm sorry. Can we even say that on TV? I take that back. Actually, what I'm looking for is a nice young lady with hoe-like qualities. Fellas know what I'm talking about.
It's someone.
Cause I saw this one lady, boy, she had, can we say backs? She had backs, and she looked like a horse. Just like a thoroughbred stallion, Jack. I said, baby, what's your name? And she walked up, she said, pfft. Nice crowd, man. It's a trip, man, because, like, I'm just dressed, you know. But, you know, like, Jamie, aren't you scared? You look like a gang member. I was like, man, come on. Yeah, and I know, you know, they got that, like, we all look alike syndrome. And I knew this one lady, this white lady, she was out there. She was looking at me. And I know she didn't know who I was. Cause I just told her I was doing comedy, right? And I knew she thought I was somebody else. Cause she was just sitting there staring at me like, oh my God. Oh my God. You're Eddie Murphy. I was like, oh, man. And I just played along with it. She's like, I just said if I ever saw Eddie Murphy, I was just going to rip my clothes off and make love to him. I was like, really? I'll be Eddie tonight. She wasn't too bright, man. Because I told her, I said, look, I'm not Eddie. Then, are you Paul Rodriguez? I was like, do you like Paul Rodriguez? She was like, yes, I love him. I was like, well, you never know, Holmes. Just might be him. It's a trip, though, man, because, like, I trip out. Well, just the way things are, like, you know, the black and white things and stuff. Because I like looking at, like, white people when they, like, discipline their kids in public. Have you ever seen a white lady, like, do that? They do it peacefully. Shh, peacefully. I saw this lady scream whispering at her kids. She was like, Jimmy, get over here. Let there be some black parents in the mall, huh? Your mama bust your ass, won't she? Jamie, Andrew, Jamal, and Dashiki? You don't bring your black narrow ass over here, boy. I'll whoop your ass in this mall. And parents, my parent would hit. Black parents would hit you anywhere, Jack, with anything they got. My grandmother slapped me retarded one time. Oh, Granny, I ain't come to... It's cool, guys. Cool to have you guys here, man. Just trying to do a little something for the community. Just hope that... Well, that wasn't funny. I'm trying to be serious now. Aren't you scared? Just aren't you scared? How you guys feel, man? Just say, hell no, I ain't scared. Hell no, I ain't scared. Having a good time. You missed your turn, dear. She's like, hell no, I ain't scared. Tell you what, man, I'm gonna let you guys go, man. I'm just thanking for letting me be here. I'm through, man. You guys have been great, man. Peace. Now, Jamie Foxx, man.
Tell me about your first drive-by shooting and how you felt.
Being shot or driving by?
Being shot at or shooting?
So, you know, your heart jump, you sweat, but you think about the stuff that had happened to you and your homeboys, and you say, no remorse, I don't care.
Being shot at in your life is regular?
Yeah, well, down there when you have a lot of shootings. You know, he come out already, coming out of my house, I already got shot, you know, bah, right there.
We rolled up on some gangbangers, but, you know, they didn't know, they thought we were some of their homeboys, right? And, we pulled up on them, and one of them came up to the car. So, we shot me and my homeboy, we shot him, like, 7 times in the face, and he fell, you know, he just drove off.
Point blank?
Yeah.
Why?
Because we don't get along with them. We don't like them. They shot one of my homeboys. We got him.
Me and my brother grew up together. And, you know, we stayed together for a long time. We stuck together. So my stepfather came, and he told me that my brother got killed. And we found out the person who did it. And so, you know, I just left. Went out trying to come up, make some money. So I can go out and get this food.
Let's say you're with your homies, you get them, you kill them. What happens to you?
I'm just gonna take off, park, and get out, look at him, and just keep shooting him. Cause there ain't no more face in, on his body. And then I'm gonna be happy. I'm gonna feel better. Cause I paid him back.
Do you ever stop to think that that young man that you guys shot 7 times in the face, that his mama cried to death, that his sisters, that his family, that somebody misses him?
Yeah, but that's, you know, that's not my problem.
How does someone like you lose that humanity? How do you lose being human? How is it that you can take a life and not sweat it?
I'm just as much human as you or anybody else, you know what I'm saying? But it's like I took a lot of losses. I took a lot of losses.
Tell me about those losses. How many homeboys have you lost?
Name off names or what?
Just round it off for me, numbers.
Bizarro, TR, Pine, Rampage, Uncle BB, Stacy Loco. Who else?
It's all right, man. You're almost out of fingers.
That's about like 7 or 8 West Dog, Lil Mobot. And when I think of that, you know, my heart dropped because I grew up with West Mobot on 105th when we was little and we didn't know nothing about gangbanging.
Do you know the activity that you're doing? You are sending a message to your chavalitos, to your little brothers, that they want to be like you, eh?
I talked to him. You gotta go to school and do something that I didn't do, you know.
How are you gonna feel, carnal? One of these days, when because of your affiliation with some gang, it could cost them their life.
I thought about it a lot, man. It's like I'll do something crazy, though, man. I don't want it to come to that point, though, you know. I always tell my mom, you know, move out somewhere. Just you guys, I'll stay here, you know. I'm gonna stay here or. Or if I could, I'll leave, you know, and let them leave their own little lives.
Where's your dad?
Penitentiary.
Do you see him?
I think he's supposed to make parole this year, though.
Do you want to see him?
Don't matter. I ain't seen him in all this time, you know. It wouldn't be like, wow, daddy's coming home or nothing, because I've been my own dad. My mom been my mom. He's just going to be another person around the house.
Do you see a future for yourself?
Future of what?
A future.
Do you mean jobs and babies
yes.
and stuff like that? I see a child, maybe. I don't see no, you know, doctor, dentist, nothing like that. I just see, you know.
Even if you could get out, all the shootings and all the things that you did, that bill is still outstanding?
Oh, yeah, just that, like if I quit gangbanging today and I got out of here, right?
And I was walking down the street, you know. I sound like my enemy. He sound like some push-ups rolled up on me or something like that. And I tell him, I don't gangbang no more. But you know, so what? They do. You know, remember all the shit you did to me? It don't change nothing. You know, you can't change your face.
Why can't you get out?
I don't want to get out.
Why don't you want to get out? You done been shot once. What are you, immortal?
You know, it's like when I think about it at home, sometimes I lay on the bed and I'll be like, damn, this shit is way out. My mind, you know, I just start thinking all kind of stuff like, if you get out, well, what you gonna do? What you good for? What you know how to do? Nathan. I don't know how to do nothing, you know. I ain't been in no trade school. I'm 17, working in the ninth grade. I don't see no, you know.
All you know how to do is what?
It's kicky.
Gangbang?
Basically.
How old were you when you first started to run with them?
12 years old.
12 years old.
It was my choice.
Do you really believe that a 12-year-old
mm-hmm.
can make that choice?
Well, a 12-year-old is still a child.
That's
and a child's not going to use good judgment. I felt that being in a gang would make me cool and accepted amongst my peers. It wasn't the peer pressure, but the fact that I wanted to belong myself. And me being a child, I'm not using good judgment. I moved from playing cowboys and robbers and Indians and all that straight to gangbanging. It was just a game to me. It was another thing to click into.
I'm here to try to, at least I'm going to try to stop some of it. Because if I wouldn't have stopped, it would probably have been more crimes committed out there by me. Mm-hmm. But I woke up. I thought about it.
I'd watched these movies all these years. When a guy gets shot, he get up and he run by 20 blocks or 100 miles. And the coldest thing that got to me, when I got shot, I couldn't move. And next I sat down there and I thought I was dying because this is not what life has showed me. Life has shown me that bullets wasn't too dangerous, that you can't get shot in the leg, neck, or arm, or foot, and keep running or go play basketball the next day, but that's not true. And that's what society does. They play a game on our heads as little kids. And then they wonder why we act a certain way as adults.
You know what the fighting is over?
It's like a competition-like thing, you know.
Like playing basketball, baseball,
just getting who
football.
Is better than who.
Who's the best.
Who got the best shoes and the best, you know,
who can
gold.
Fight the best.
Yeah, who can fight the best, who got the most cars, the girls, you know, the material things. And a lot of people got jealous.
The great American.
It's
American.
True. First it is all. A bunch of jealousy out there in the streets, because I had a sister and her husband was murdered over the same bullshit. And it's just a bunch of jealousy. Now, if they can just get along and pull together, it wouldn't be none of this.
I see a young brother over here. What happened to you, my man?
I got shot in 89, and I got shot in 90.
Over what?
Gangbanging.
Do you want to change your life? Do you want to get out of this?
Not really. They already smoked half of our homeboys.
You won't get out because is it too late?
I can get out, but sometimes I think about it, sometimes I don't want to.
And the whole thing is like this. He's in the mode where this is what life has to offer him. And if this is what life has to offer him, he's going to do it the best he can. See, a lot of us grew up in the gangbanging. And gangbanging be the only thing we got.
Ain't there a point where you ain't gonna cheat death? One of these days, that bullet gonna find its mark, and the only thing you want on your gravestone is that he lived and he died? What happened in between?
When I grew up, you know, it wasn't heavy as it was, but as I got older, it's tough, you know, but I changed my life, you know, after I served my time in the youth authority. I came home. And everybody was looking up upon me as, ooh, he out, you know, and I seen it, and, you know, but I changed that. See, I seen the difference, you know, of a people. You know, I could talk to the young in the people growing up and tell them this is not what to do.
let's talk about what do they have to look up to, Paul. You know, the dope dealers with the gold, they're having money, they're driving with $33,000 rims on their cars. Okay, money is no big deal. Check out what they have for example. Okay, none of us here are executives of any corporation. So how can he look forward to being executive of a corporation? None of us here have high level jobs or big nice cars and big nice houses. How can he look forward to that, Paul? So what does he have to look forward to when he's in his community? All he has to look forward to is either getting in a gang or getting himself a dope sack, and that seems like it's the only way out of the ghetto situation. But we know now that we're all older, we've all been through that, that there's only that doesn't get you out of your poverty. It basically only gets you into the penitentiary, and right there all of your freedom gone and all of your rights are gone. So it's like a dead end street, Paul. It's a do or die situation. It's a do or die situation. It's our only alternative.
You know, Rolling Stone magazine called this group the most important group of the 90s for their social commentary. I call them my friends, but you know them as Public Enemy. Give it up!
Get to the roof and give keeping it up. Prepare me loose. Then again, I got a story that's hard in the heart. Cause from the Holocaust, I think about the world that's going on. I know where I found that dumb Billy down from the base where I land. The place of the cross invaded by the whack. Kitty whack and fooled the black and left them standing. King and chief probably had a big beat. Because of that, now I grit my teeth. So here's a song to the soul about the shake of the face. And a smile went along with that. Can't trust it.
Watch your step, boy.
Here it comes.
Watch your step, boy.
Here it comes.
On the drum, boy.
Here it comes.
We didn't quit, boy.
Here come the drums.
Yeah, that's right. We the men.
Here it comes.
We the men. You just missed
it. Here it comes now. All right. Put your fist in there. Pump it up. Come on, you. Come on, Al. And you drop the bass. Pump it up. Come on. You drop the bass. That's right, Al.
¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Cómo están? Damn, man. Look like Jackie Robinson here. How are you? People are beautiful, man. I ain't gonna ask you where you from, because it don't really matter today. Today, where we're from, we're God's children. That's where we're from. Yeah, you people have been terrific, man. Let me see what I got. Yo, yo. What's up? Damn, you barely fit in that seat. Get on. Get on. Get on. I'm coming back to the hood. Damn, took a lot of egg whites to get this all up. That's what my mama used to do. Back in my mother's day, they didn't have no Aquanet. My mom would just beat two eggs, Jack. She, you know what? Chicano girls get it like, that makes us look taller, doesn't it? Yeah. 3 foot two with that hairdo, you're 6 foot. You playing basketball.
You two are sisters. You have a baby. You have two kids, and you're gonna have a baby.
Yeah.
And the father of your kid is where?
In jail. Incarcerated.
Over what?
Murder.
And you have your the father of this baby. Where's he at?
In jail.
Over what?
Files of narcotics.
And your mama and your daddy are where?
In jail.
My goodness. And all of it has to do with a gang affiliation.
Pretty much, yeah.
How old are you?
18.
You're 18. You're gonna raise this baby by yourself?
Yeah.
Tell me about it.
It's hard. I didn't expect this. I mean, I knew he was in gangs and everything, but, you know, there's only so much you can do to try to help him, and, you know.
Young ladies, gang members or otherwise, they have the privilege of crossing boundaries, right, without no problem?
No, no, some girls can just, you know, go out and, like us, for instance, we know so many different gang members to where is we safe going over into like 30 neighborhood because we know 30. We safe going over into Hoover neighborhood because we live over there. And we, you know, we can go in different places because we don't disrespect no one for them to disrespect us.
I understand that they shot up your house here not too long ago.
Yes.
Over what?
Because, like two dudes around here like me, but I don't like them. And they mad because I don't want to talk to them.
So let me ask you, because they like you, they shot up your house?
Oh, what else? Because I kicked it with the 40s and I'll kick it with the 30s.
You just got shot, right?
Mm-hmm.
How did that happen?
It was a drive-by. I was standing out. Well, I was going home, and when I walked in the gate, some guys had drove by giving off their gang slang, was shooting at another gang whose hood I was walking through, and I caught the bullet. Out of all the bullets that was shot, I was the only one who was shot.
Why does that happen all the time? It seemed like, man, these guys is bad shots.
The guys that have guns, I really think they don't know how to shoot. They just want the gun because they think they're bad. They think they're hard because they have a gun.
and they're not hard at all. They don't make, it doesn't make them look good at all.
They try to make themselves look good.
Well, what is it about? Do they get a lot of respect by capping?
They think they get a lot of respect
by capping. Most of them, like, they feel that if you, like, you know, they call you baby something or little something, but if you go out and kill somebody from another set, then you become an OG, you know, original gang member.
You become a man
that
way?
Yeah, you know, they figure that you higher and you got a better chance of making it in a gang but if you know how to use the gun.
Does the fact that a young man either belongs to the Bloods or to the Crips, does that make him more appealing to you all?
No, not at all.
You like gangbangers?
Yeah, because my people is gangbangers.
What is it about them that make them?
They just different. They just do crazy stuff. And all the boys that gangbang are cute.
Aren't you afraid for your life? I mean, they shot up through your window.
The 40s didn't do it. That's just the 30s.
But it don't matter from the 40s to the 30s. A bullet ain't got no identification.
True.
You lost your husband.
Mm-hmm.
How long ago?
3 years ago.
And if it's not too painful, can you tell me how?
We were at my cousin's party, and we were going to go home. So one of the guys wanted a ride right here in the parking lot. So we took him, and we were standing out there for a while. My husband was joking around with my brothers and all the guys, the peewees and stuff. And me and my comadre was towards the street, we were talking, and my husband came, and he was talking to my compadre and everything, and then my comadre had told me that there was a car right there, you know, that, you know, who were they? And I had like, nothing, you know, I'm used to it. I just said, oh, they're probably drug dealers, they're coming to buy some drugs or something. No, it wasn't. They rolled down the window and they started shooting.
And the ones who really pay the price are you, the ladies, the women.
What the problem is now with our Latinos and our blacks coming up, they got this ego that it's the white man doing everything to them. When they got this in their head that the white man is doing it to them, it's making them, you know, just, oh, well, it's the white man. But they have to realize it's them themselves. You know, it's not the white man going out killing another white man. It's the brothers killing the brothers and the Latinos killing the Latinos.
My son, my husband died. He said, Mom, I know where my daddy's gun is. I'm going to kill the guy that killed my dad. You know, and that's sad to hear that, you know. And then you get so mad that you want to say, you know, you feel like, I felt like telling him, you know. No, I feel like telling them, you know, mijo, one of these days, you know, we're going to get them, you know, we're going to get them that did that to your dad. But you know, I can't because I have to think about, you know, him. You know, he's already big. He's 13. You know, he's already getting in gangs and stuff, you know. And I be chasing him.
He's not. He's a kid, 13 years old. I was worried about my bicycle. I had a flat tire.
Yeah, but when you're going, up like a barrio like this, there's no bicycle to think about. Gangs to think about.
Tell me about your mama. What did she tell you?
She always told us, you know, not to get involved in it. And, you know, always try to move away. But no matter where we moved to, we always ended up moving right back to Harvard City. And she always told us, you know you're going to follow my footsteps, you know, especially me, because I was always getting in trouble and, you know, smoking shrooms and all that stuff, you know, when I was younger, you know. And I never really used to get in trouble, but she just used to tell me to stop doing it because, you know, she knew that I was just, you know, acting like her when she was young. So, you know, like when me and my sister, you know, came up pregnant at age 16, you know, my mom never got mad at us or, you know, never hit us or anything. She was just hurt because she seen that she knew already that we were following her footsteps. And, you know, now there's nothing she could do about it. You know, she's in jail and we're out here. So it's like,
what are you going to feel when this little cutie is 16 years old and she's pregnant?
I'm going to pray to God that I'll be moved out of here before then, before she even grows up in this environment. Already my son's 4 years old, and he already throws up Harper City and goes around saying Harper City
throwing,
gang.
You mean he throws the gang sign?
He goes like this, throws up the H for Harper City. He talks a lot about, you know, like the guys from Wilmington and, you know, like saying F them and F this, and tries to write on the wall with markers, Harvard City Gang. And the guys, all the homeboys around here already gave him a nickname. They call him Little Gumby. And he's only 4 years old. That's my son right there.
Hey, I'm Paul. How you doing? What do you want to be when you grow up?
A homeboy.
I want to thank you, and I think that Chucky D, Flavor Flav, and myself are begging you, stop the madness. Stop killing each other. Have a good night. Take a positive message to the neighborhood. Do something with your lives. Peace.
Hi, I'm Sissy Spacek.
And I'm Olga Corbett.
No, we're really not, but we're dressed like them.
And we're here to tell you about the Thanksgiving night lineup here on Fox, The Simpsons, Drexel's Class, and Beverly Hills 90210.
Right on, girlfriend. And then, thank goodness, it's Fox Friday. You can watch The Simpsons, Charlie Hoover, In Living Color, and Herman's Head.
Men are pigs, aren't they? Sorry, I was getting carried away.
Tuesday night at 8, Stallone fights a superhuman Russian in Rocky IV. Stay tuned for Tales from the Dark Side, next, only on Fox 49.